If you're already making travel plans for this summer with a dog or another pet, we have some important advice this morning from Christina Selter, who runs a national program called Bark Buckle Up. Good morning, Christina.
Good morning.
And Luke is here as well, we should point out, just chilling in his seatbelt. Is this doggy seatbelt?
This is the original doggy seatbelt. It's not even available yet. This is brand new, first time seen. Basically, you hook it on like a leash and then click it right into the seatbelt. So you can ride in the back seat, you can sit, stand, lay down, but not escape the vehicle.
Oh, that's great. Okay, and we'll show how it works in the car in just a minute. But what is this? It looks like a car seat.
It's actually a car seat. It's a bed on the bottom. It's nice and soft in here, so you can get
this
comfy.
This is not for Luke.
This is for small dogs or cats. It's a carrier, car seat, and a bed. So all three functions, very affordable.
Okay.
Then of course, this is another carrier, but it's airline approved. So then you can take your smaller pet, dog or cat, onto the plane with you.
Oh, that's great.
So from the car to the plane.
All right, so let's show these in action. First of all, we chose this car deliberately because it's very pet friendly, isn't it?
This is actually the Ford Edge, and it was picked the top dog. So in the top 10 list, it made top dog because of its features that make it so pet friendly and safe. It has a one touch in the back that puts the seat down. So if you want to put more crates or more pets, you're gonna have half a seat down or all of it down, put four crates, everybody, the whole family fits.
That's great, let's get Luke in
there.
Let's
go in, come on.
Hop in, boy.
Come on.
Oh, Luke doesn't want to go in the car.
There's a big truck.
All right, don't worry, don't force him if he doesn't want to. That's okay, let's just show the doggy car seat here. Come here, babe.
Got him?
You don't have to go, Luke.
The doggy car seat, we've got the little Yorkie sitting in there, all safe and happy.
So he still has the car seat attached, even though he has
absolutely
a car seat.
Any crates or car seats, carriers, anything has to be buckled in. You don't want anything flying through the vehicle. Exactly.
And they're in the back on purpose because you don't want pets in the front seat, right?
Exactly. The airbag, small children, pets, never in the front seat.
Always in the back. And the farther back, the better, right? So if you can even put them in the trunk.
Exactly.
Let's go. Oh, somebody take Luke. I don't want to bring him on the street. There you go. All right.
So here we go. We just open the back. Oh, we've got Bowser in here.
Bowser is the best.
He's a brand new puppy. He's sitting here nice and safe. You buckle in your crates, your car seats. He can travel back here safely. As you see, he's getting worn out. He's tired from this morning.
How does this not move?
You want to tether it in to the D-rings. You want to hook anything in, even suitcases, whatever you have in your vehicle, secure it because it can become a projectile through the vehicle. And a dog his size would be about 2,000 pounds of projectile. So you want to secure everything.
What kind of dog is he?
He's actually an American Mastiff.
Oh, he's so beautiful. Can I touch him?
Absolutely.
Hi, Bowser. Oh, you're so cute. Oh, thank you for the kisses. Thank you.
He is so adorable.
What other things should we bring along on a road trip?
For the whole family, you want to make sure that you would have some type of first aid kit, especially if you're going on spring vacation and be in the car while. You want to have that handy. Reflective gear. Hiking, camping, walking your dog at night, put on their reflective gear along with yours. If you're going out in the cold, which it was cold here this morning, any of these little boots to protect their feet.
That is so cute.
On snow, ice, anything.
I've never seen those before. I didn't know they made doggy booties.
And then we also, if they visit our website, the barkbuckleup.com website, they get free pet safety kits. You put all your pet information, their photo. It comes with the decal that goes on the driver's door. You keep that in your glove box. If there is an emergency, police and fire have all of your pet information and they can get them to safety.
Because pets are people too, right?
They are part of the family.
And so what do you mean a pet safety kit? Does it come with something other than the car?
The cards go in the glove box, the decal goes on your window. When a policeman sees this on your driver's door, he knows that you may have a pet in the vehicle that will need to get to safety.
Okay, but all these other things that you have to purchase yourself, you don't offer it on the web.
BarkBuckleup is an awareness program. Okay. We teach safety, but there are links. They can find the products on there and purchase them online or in stores.
Great stuff, Christina. Thank you. And so we're going to put your website on our website. So all you have to do is go to earlyshow.cbsnews.com and get all this great information about traveling with your pet.
A lot happens early on The Early Show, weekday mornings on CBS.